All right, here we go. Grand Finals. Hammerheart coming from losers. This is going to be an awesome game. We have this Samus, Full Blast versus... And remember I said it earlier, but for anyone like just starting, especially if the VOD just starts now, Club actually sent Hammerheart two losers a while ago, and Hammerheart just made the run all the way back in. So you know if it's one of Shears' tournaments and there's a rematch, you know it's got to be far down in the bracket. And the format is typically, although it's not waterfall technically, but I think it's still, I think he still knows how to run a bracket so that you don't, you avoid any possible rematches as early as possible. And great down B, and just calls out. Dude, that was great because, like, if he tried to follow up, which I definitely would have tried to follow up just because I don't know the timing, you know? Like, DK can always just throw out that upbeat, man. That's just, like, the ultimate just, like, it's the helicopter of transportation where, like, the helicopter just zoom out, like let's get out of here. And it's actually the same way in this game because...
Yeah, and as you were saying this, he had a great edge guard with that upbeat at a pretty low percentage.
But,
on
but Hammerheart waited it out the one stock, and he gets the conversion on the stock.
The downside of that upbeat is that you're very vulnerable from both the top and the bottom. As you see there, Samus
man,
just a really easy spike.
He doesn't get the punish, and Hammerheart, yeah, he gets these upbeats, like... Dude... Samus has an upbeat air parry, dude. It is an air parry. That's what it is. And Hammerheart will do these. I mean, but he should be able to DI out of it. That's the thing. Is like he should be able to like DI out of it and punish. And it, but like you saw Hammerheart land and then she immediately throw out another one.
Yep.
That's why Samus is so much better in Japanese version and has more invincibility in the Japanese version. But Hammerheart looking to close this out. Oh, great wait. He doesn't even try and punish. And he's coming up with a, what was that? And then he just had to do a panic up B, and he actually got punished for it this time.
Yeah.
And still getting back. Real hard to edge guard. Hard.
Samus is really good off
stage.
He's
really got the sweet spot down.
Yep. DK makes it back. Shields the light charge shot. And that'll be game one.
And a nice three-star from Hammerheart. Looking real good there. Didn't get a chance to see their set earlier. I'm not sure if it was streamed or not here.
I'm also not sure.
And I'm not sure what the score of their last match was. If anyone in the chat knows and is looking at the bracket. Beautiful spacing, but I don't know if he meant to do a dash attack there. Pretty early. And wow, Hammerheart was going like a beautiful fade, and he just throws out that down air enough to cover out the whole thing. And there we see an uppy in neutral from Bubba.
With another nice conversion, can turn into another combo, misreads the roll.
I thought he was going to try and read tech with... he wanted the feet. That
yeah.
would have been real pretty.
Anyway, yeah, Hammerheart avoiding that up B edge
there,
guard from earlier.
Yeah, he gets punished for basically going, if it's not true, you know, then Samus is going to be able to get that up B out. And it's really up to the person's DI. Oh, I wonder, I don't know if he, maybe he was just trying to call out tech there. And nice. I thought he was going to forward smash, but...
Makes it back to the ledge.
I wonder if he throws out the grab at all for edge guarding purposes. I know. I don't know how... Like, I think... I don't know if DK has a way to get underneath it, if that sounds right. Oh, gets up from the ledge, rolls. And goes to turn around, and it's just too late.
Not
almost
enough.
Almost a beautiful turnaround.
And a call but really high percentage. This would be an easy edge guard from Hammerheart.
Gets the invincibility on the arms with the... and then he just gets punished after the fact with the Ursa down air. Mm-hmm. Alright, so just things. Hammerheart just doing shield get up from the ledge, and
that'll be a shield break.
Beautiful
up B is a really
shield
strong
break.
Shield break. See what a punish he
gets. Down
not
smash.
Very good. Two nairs,
I wonder
and
if
then
he
gets
wanted,
off stage.
I thought he could have done like another shield drop nair, and yeah, the down smash can be weaved around. And if it can be weaved around, then you bet your bottom dollar that Hammerheart will weave around it. Seriously, he's the LD of like Falcons with like his recovery, man. He's crazy.
Of Falcons?
Of Falcons, right.
Yeah. Hammerheart taking another stock, making this a closer game. It's a very high percentage. Back throw from DK might kill at this percent. I don't know them well enough.
Nice fade. He's like going in the stage. Look how he like he's going left to the whole like start of the uppie and then just holding right afterwards. Like the perfect spot though. Look at this weight
and
another
shield break.
And we got two back airs and he was able to shield the forward smash. Doing a nice pivot spacing and
unfortunate SD.
It's unfortunate. How much percent did he just have? That was like pretty low. That really just kind of turns down the game here, and let's see.
Especially with Hammerheart opening with that small combo.
Good
off stage,
here.
But not dead.
Yeah, Hammerheart didn't really have a follow-up there. And
great edge guard by Clubba.
Yeah, when Samus goes low, you're like, I don't know. Although we've seen Hammerheart, I was about to say, I feel like there's a disadvantage lower. Goes for that just disjointed down air and thought he was going to go left and he was kind of giving himself more options where, so good tech right by Clubba there.
Oh, there's that perfect land you mentioned earlier.
Just a pretty land onto the side platform of that down B. Beautiful space, run through him, just called it out like.
And that'll be it.
That's a great.
Hammerheart taking game.
Unfortunate SD by Clubba, his second stock, but Hammerheart capitalizes on that one. Great game, that's 2-0. I guess we're going to be doing a nice. I'm going to go get a drink of water real fast. All
right.
It's dry AF. All
right, we're going into game 3. Hammerheart not taking that step back as he did the previous 2 games when he starts to charge. I know Mr. Sir does that a lot as well. He moves to the back of the platform, and there's that upbeat. Doesn't quite get the shield break. Then he gets open into a combo and drops it.
Yo, what up? It's Raz.
That's your water.
The water fountain. It's a great water fountain.
Nice and cold.
Did you know on the West Coast they call them drinking fountains?
That's weird.
What weirdos, dude. That's a thing, dude. Drinking fountains.
Doesn't get the down air and misses the Z cancel.
Clubba definitely having some difficulty with the edge guards here. And down tilt will do it.
Yeah.
It's great. Like Hammerheart almost has an option to make. Like he's like one of the only Samuses that. I mean, I don't want to say one of the only Samuses. I watch him all the time, and he's very good with the tilts. Like he uses all of Samus's moves. It's weird.
Even up tilt.
Going
unfortunately, doesn't get that
a little too hard there. Yeah, it looked like. He was going real low, but like he knows that. He knows that spot, like that sweet spot better than anyone, so.
Maybe not down air.
Maybe not anyone. Maybe anyone.
Well, no, probably not as good as like Josuke, but.
Yeah.
I don't know. One thing we actually watched and found earlier that Clubba was talking about is
but
there
he
was
does
a,
it in Japanese version, like
yeah,
the recovery's so different there.
Yeah.
Just because of how much invincibility frames Samus gets from the and the ability to like not really like DI out of it is a lot tougher. And here we go, 2-2. Yeah, welcome back. Okay, I just realized this game's 2-2.
Yep.
I feel like I didn't commentate this game at all.
It's really quick, it hasn't been 2 minutes yet. Hey,
I'll be safe and again, it's so scary for both of these guys to really go in. This is such like a boxing matchup where like a lot of times you're not gonna have a follow-up because the DK or the Samus is going to have like an up B, like just to defend themselves, you know? Like DK's is what, frame 1 or something like that? Something crazy. I don't know if it's exactly frame 1, but and Samus even has like invincibility at the start. Like I said, like Samus's up B is an air parry, and so they're kind of just exchanging hits here. Like this is such a, again, I mentioned that earlier. I wonder if he was gonna start bringing out the grab because it's pretty good.
especially with GK.
It's like, yeah,
gigantic,
yeah.
Hurt box.
There's not too many. Oh, was going for another.
Another shield break.
A shield break. Thought we were gonna see a wind cancel.
And that was
nice,
a great combo from
nice,
Flubba,
yeah,
to finish out that stock.
I think Hammerheart had a chance to tech, and maybe he was like choosing not to tech, and then just a quick reactionary follow up. Just down air into the ground. And look at that. What did he? What just clanked? Something just clanked. Oh, he gets underneath it. So yeah, it's definitely able to like underneath the palm, but he kind of did it like a little early. And this is the last game. Let's see if Hammerheart can 3-0 this. He's got percent, but. And forward air, nair. Does it. Good DI from Clubba. And that little, oh, that would have been
a
beautiful edge guard. See that little upbeat. Look at the crouch cancel. Or that little neutral B, like edge guard earlier.
Yep.
Oh, runs into a back air, like the very later part of the duration. And he, dude, he's so patient with the shield pressure.
That
on
nair,
and
does
nair
it.
Will do it.
Hammerheart takes
so Hammerheart,
set one. 3-0.
We got a bracket reset 3-0. I wonder if Club, like, is he firmly sticking to DK or is he thinking right now?
I don't know. He did beat Hammerheart earlier and. Alright, well, set two doesn't fit in.
Yeah, here we go. Look,
set
two. Look, he's known. You beat him earlier, you know, so I guess, like, maybe Hammerheart can do some things. It'll be interesting if that game was recorded at all. It'd be interesting to see the differences. But let's see how the differences. It's a brand new set. Let's see if Clubba changes his, mentality of approaching it all.
I think set
let's
two.
Let's see if we start him, like, converting some edge guards. Is really, back throw off the ledge.
Strongest back throw in the game.
Oh my god. I literally said that. Said, did you hear me? And then this shield get up. And look at that. So see, he, all the time, dude, there's so many times where, like, I almost. It feels like you are winning in neutral, where, like, he throws out a move and then you kind of are, like, countering that in a way. And then he just is there with the upbeat. Like, he uses it. It's almost like he plans it in a way. Throws out a move, and he knows that if I try and punish this move, then he'll upbeat. And we see
another
edge
break.
Guard, another and this time he does reverse. I love that. If he had gone forward, I think he had some really good DI left, and that really messed with him. But again, there's not too many, like. I mean, maybe there is, but I'm just saying, like, the amount of combos that, like, DK at, like, nothing, it's almost, like, unsafe in a way to even try and continue your combo again because you just get upbeat, and here you go. There's the upbeat. Clubba kind of getting punished for going in, and, did he DI out of that one? I'm not sure. It's kind of, like, how they react to the upbeats, like, you should technically be able to just DI out and punish them.
It's still very
in
difficult
theory,
to
you know?
DI,
yeah, and then you can still end up, like, teching or something.
Yeah.
And here we go. Hammerheart, nice fastball back air in the neutral. And
that grab again.
This time, he's going to recover that high. He's going to go lower and just edge. Yep. Edge high will do it. And he's up in stock looking to go for his fourth straight game. And I love when he spaces with those, like, little dashes. And he, like, only uses a dash when he needs it. Would have been awesome.
Did he hit any charge shots?
Yeah, just a little. It didn't look like it was there. Mm-hmm. Possibly due to a good DI. And oh, there you go. So God. He DIs out of that, but Hammerheart's already shielding. So just not fast enough on the punish. Or maybe, like, the way that he DI'd out of it, it just kind of didn't work for him. Like, it could be not even. I don't know if it's even possible to. I don't know if there is time for him to get a punish, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, down to reaching. I never saw last set. Also,
again,
one thing,
yeah.
I want to mention what Hammerheart does, so when he's on the ledge, he generally shields that down air that Club is coming down with, and he slides back off to the ledge and can punish. And then when Clubba was on the side platform, he did the same thing to him. Clubba was shielding, pushed him off, and then immediately upbeat as a counter.
Oh, yeah.
So just,
Oh, and again, we see the neutral B, like, he's like, he throws, every now and then he just throws this, like, beautiful just neutral B just to clip him so that it just forces him to, like, get the edge again, and this time the down tilt doesn't work and he grabs him from real far away on his way up, and that's it.
That's
and
game
nice
one of set
rinsing
two
restock. Bubba definitely seemed to have like some trouble converting stocks. But again, like I said, Samus is so like the combos. I don't know how many combos like there are, and like if they're not perfectly true, then you kind of just get into an uppie. Really, like what he needs to be doing better, I think, is just the DI after the uppies, and then I guess if you DI out quick enough and early enough, you then even have like a decision to make of like, are they gonna land on platform or not? And you should be able to technically punish like both options. Theoretically, I say. Again, it's easier said than done, but. Yeah. And here we go, there's the up B in neutral that we see kind of going back and forth. And there we go. Nice
tech chase off stage.
Grab. I don't think he even needed a dash. And
holds the edge to get that.
Great edge hog
for the stock.
Yeah, that's probably the way the edge guard, you know. But,
and he went
then
out.
It becomes close, though. Like, you got to get there before whatever has a chance to hit you. Like, if he sees that, like, he's not going to fade back if he sees that you're going to try an edge hog. He's just going to hit you with that up B, and then that's, like, just a dangerous spot to be.
Which is why you saw Clubba go out there to try to
DI back to stage, though.
Yeah, fake the up B, as he's been doing.
Oh, great wave on that back air. He just dodges that back air, and then just, like... It's so crazy because I feel like Samus in a way has to like you almost have to make your decision in the air on like whether or not you're gonna go like left and right, if that makes sense. Like, other characters you can almost like react in the air, but like Hammerheart, I feel like before that jump happened, we knew that he was gonna be holding left to kind of like fade back and then right on like the next hit, and that would be enough. You know, like he has to make the decision. And going real far down, and no response there.
He's gonna down air
edge guarding purposes. Yeah, I guess he like didn't like where he was at, and goes for a nair. I wonder if he was trying for like an up air. And clap. Yep. Nice. So Clubba bringing this back.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Just hops up. Was that a tech chase? I think. And yep. So that's something we haven't really seen is the. And the great, see, that was a great job by Clubba, though, where he didn't go in, knowing that he was going to, like he almost fakes the go in, gets Hammerheart to do that. He actually didn't get the punish, and then got upbeat again, but I still think it's ended up in his favor. He DI'd out of the upbeat. So definitely looks better here, and Hammerheart sitting on this left edge, and wow. He just hit him with, like, the top part of that down air as he was shield dropping. Crazy,
and the back row kill all the way on the left.
Ooh, and don't think he wanted to run off there. It's sucks that he just had to drop. Tries to hit.
Gets back.
Great, yeah, great recovery. He was a real low.
And makes it around that slap.
Oh, the teleport. Here we go, let's just watch and observe. Running, jumps up in air, but Clubba shields it. And
great down air.
Get off the ledge, that he calls out. That's his answer now. If he's gonna fade back, up even, and he has enough time to just pop off ledge.
And then Hammerheart's gonna have to find an answer to that over the course of the next three games. You have 1-1 in set 2 here of Grand
Prix. Teleport up smash.
Oh yeah, Samus's amazing teleport.
No, he did that to me the other day in our game. Like, yeah, I probably shouldn't have said that just in case he wanted to throw it out, but.
I mean, he kind of smiled and laughed and said that.
Yeah. So, your first game goes to Clubba. Right? Or no, wait, that was game 2?
That was game 2, so it's 1-1.
So it's 1-1. Ooh, nice. So he hops up with up air, shields it, but he immediately gets the punish with the grab. And he went for it again, and this time Hammerheart just upbees out of shield. So there you go. We saw Hammerheart make one adapt, like adaptation right there. Back to back hits.
Oh, and that bomb really
first time he gets hit by it,
prevented that edge guard.
He needs the upbeat out of shield right then and there. And there we go. There's the down tilt. Yeah. So it almost like his decision kind of a lot of times matters on how high is Donkey Kong up.
Yeah.
You know, and if it
pass. Great spike.
And there you go, we get the conversion. Bringing this to a quick three-shot game. And
that up smash just does so much damage.
I think at like a weird spot, it like breaks shield. I don't know if it's like... I don't know if you have to be... I don't know if it's getting on the ground.
Even then,
and
it
the
just
jab,
does...
I wonder if he crouch gets on that. Oh, I think he purposely crouch gets on that, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it's a tough recovery, and yeah, grab and
exactly,
throw.
Exactly, so if he's
repeat.
A little bit higher, he's a little bit higher, then the grab works. And he knew he wasn't getting back there, that was a little scary. Nice little mind games there in the middle of, like, he dodges invisibility and kind of even gets, like, the punish out. Looking real quick and kick. Bubba definitely looking, like, pretty aggressive right now with these back airs that he's throwing out toward him. Oh my god, did that hit him? That was so filthy. Oh, and the invisible arm, and he doesn't fade back at all, so this time he just heads straight into it. And beautiful forward air and a forward smash to close it out. Kind of just covers him. Shears made some joke. Hammer Hart having a good time. Oh, great. Oh, he wanted to clap, but nah, he was too low.
I also don't know if that would have killed.
I don't know, or maybe he had to just, smash. Like, nice. Wow, and that neutral B gives him the space back. And look at this. Doesn't even throw out the back unless he needs to, you know. He just puts that there, saying, hey, what do you want to do with this? Kind of like Indiana Jones when he...
missing the top plat to follow up with an up smash twice in a row. Back air
and
will
back
not
air
kill.
Does not take the stock. Wonder if it's stale. I mean, that's kind of what DK's got space with.
Yeah.
And he does this hop off down air. If Hammerheart, he probably could have DI, but I don't think he was really expecting that.
And back there should do
chase
it.
Chase with the grab. JV3.
Anyway, Hammerheart up 2-1 here in set 2 of Grand Finals.
So whatever problems he was having in the last game, I think Clubba was pretty aggressive there. And Hammerheart was just doing a good job of...
Yeah. And also, Hammerheart did even more recovery mix-ups, as we saw there, with the bombs to specifically prevent the up B from Donkey Kong, turning him around as well to make it harder for Donkey Kong to get back, almost turning it into a reverse edge guard.
And great wait. This is... Oh my god, that would have been... Dude, that would have been awesome to see. That was a great view, like first hit. Like that's really what he's gotta be doing. You know, like that was a nice combo from DK. And he goes for the ultimate doo-doo and just does it.
Oh, great down air.
Awesome. That was such a great option. He just waits, short hop, fastball, down air, just like when he needs it, like right at the edge to land on the edge, and that's gonna cover like at the last second. So that's, I mean, dude, if he just figured that out, that's a big game changer, I think, for like he has not really had too much success with the edge guards. And this is like too close. Dude, there's a lot of times where like when Samus can grab the ledge without a
up B.
Yeah, when she doesn't even need to use the up B and she can grab the stage, you pretty much have to like give it to her. Like she reserves it because anytime that you hit them, like they can just, if they see it coming, they can react parry with the up B.
Yep.
Like you have to respect that. And a quick one. So this time the mind games that we saw, it's funny, like this is another change up in the meta that they have, is during the invincibility when Donkey Kong was coming back, Hammerheart's been kind of like doing this little dance on the ground and then he hops up to the plat, and Clubba this time adjusted and was basically capable of punishing that exact option that he was doing and took the stock right back like with his invincibility.
He doesn't have a double jump here.
And
it's gonna be real tough to come back.
Yep.
Hammerheart evening up both stocks.
That edge guard, 40%. That's nothing for Samus.
Questionable charge shot. I guess he thought he was gonna jump up.
And he grabs. I wonder if he did mean to grab, but then.
And as we said, like before the set, you just saw how high down B popped him up.
That down air almost hit. He had like the timing right with it, but just the positioning was a little off. And I wonder if Samus would have. I wish he just did an edgehog there, just so I wonder if Samus would have grabbed that.
Yes.
I've learned not to underestimate it at all. And great, just fastball away to dodge that was that a grab attempt? I think he punished it with a back air. Now he's doing these runoff back airs, and he gets caught just trying to get in.
That won't kill, but shielding it should be an easy edge guard.
Shielding is a great option. Versus Samus a lot of the times, just because
grab is so
like,
slow.
I feel like Samus, like for shield pressuring purposes, like, I don't know, I cannot shield pressure with Samus. Hammerheart does good, like, crouch cancel jabs, he says. He's crazy. Like, if you crouch in between the jabs, like, they come out faster. Oh, and he falls off again. We saw him. That's how he had his one suicide, the one game, and he actually is finna bring this back. But see, there you go. Samus can, if you can jump to the ledge.
Oh, rolls through
great
that.
Roll. I had to have just been reactionary, really. Not sure if he was, like,
expecting it.
Yeah. Oh, and he wanted the grab. I wonder.
Get the pivot.
I'm not sure if the grab would have hit or if he got the jump out of shield, but Hammerheart was not doing the up B, you know, which I guess is the best option. And gets the spike.
And
he's on platform.
Not quite
fair
enough.
On the shield, and he's not dead, so let's see. Here we go. Is he just going to go? Does he go? Nah. If Samus can jump too.
And
back
there it is. It is 2-2 here in grand final set 2.
Crazy comeback by Pablo. That was
But he's definitely adapting to more Hammerheart's Samus shenanigans over the course of this set. He just played Mr. Sir to get into the winner's side of Grand, so a completely different style of Samus.
Oh,
than,
I didn't see that.
I didn't watch it either, but I know it's who he played right before Hammerheart, so it's a very different
Samus.
Yeah,
and again, he did play Hammerheart, so we saw him play Hammerheart earlier. Technically, the set count between them is 1-1, because Clubba sent him to, although they weren't doing best of five then.
That is correct.
So they technically each have a set over each other, and this is game 5. This is going to be an awesome game, dude. This has been an awesome grand final to watch.
Oh, yeah.
Some pretty high level, one of the highest level, I guess, like, there's not too many, like, DK mains that are at this level from Clubba.
We got
I guess we should say, even, like, in the United States, like, Yeah, Moosh's DK is pretty nice, actually. Shout out Moosh in the lab.
Your PA smash.
Rose Calamity.
Oh.
And goes for that.
Way to avoid that back air. And see, there's that thing where he waits on the ledge to be
flashbacks.
Popped off.
I'm getting flashbacks to the earlier games, you know? Like, it is now,
Well, one thing that Clubba needs to do is that he knows is that, when Samus is shielding on the ledge, every time Hammerheart is getting pushed off stage, and then can easily counter with an up B, or in that case, double jump to down air and start his combo of his own.
Yeah. And I don't know if you saw there, Clubba, like, kind of wanted to grab, but he was so far away with the grab, like, maybe playing a little safer, that he did not get, like, I think he would have gotten punished for the up B had he been closer. And great down air.
Up smash will kill, evening up the stocks.
Now, I feel like if he techs left there, I don't know if he's, I don't know if he had tech yet or if he's getting that on the tech in place. I wish I could see the replay.
Oh, great recovery by Clubba mixing up. I think that's the first time we've seen him recover high this entire set.
Yeah, definitely a different look. He's got to be, like, close enough. And Hammerheart almost outspacing that one. It was a back air he threw out. And putting up a little wall back airs, Clubba, like, playing, like, from like, above now, and there's, great spacing there by Clubba, dodging.
Oh.
And wow, that was, like, almost like a surprise up B. He's trying to hit him with the feet. He must have had success with that before, and so he's... He wouldn't be trying it otherwise, obviously.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, that shield hop was so beautiful. He did not want that.
That roll.
He did not want that roll.
Yeah. Led to a kill. However, DK's a very high percentage. There's a back air to even it up.
We got ourselves a two-stock game. Game 5.
Set 2.
Yeah, set 2. Hammerheart reset bracket after Clubba sent in losers. They're the two best low-tier players here, according to the win.
We don't know that. There were a lot of DQs.
True.
Shout out Cheers,
and
DQ and people.
A beautiful, perfect stock there by Hammerheart. Even getting the, and changing it up now in the invincibility that we saw from Donkey Kong. He's just running straight across the stage. None of the shenanigans, the jumping up to top plat.
Yeah.
don't get me wrong, the shenanigans were like working out for him. A lot of times he would get punishes, but then Clubba adapted, and then we just see a safe. Let me just run to the other side and get my neutral back.
Reads the tech roll out.
Great tech, yeah. That was like the reactionary where you're pretty much covering all tech options if you play correctly. And gets up from the ledge, rolls, uppies out of roll. Like
I feel like Clubba could react to that roll better.
A down air. It didn't look like he fell with anything. And this is last time.
Oh, great DI onto the stage.
The DI saves lives.
Well, he might have also been on stage. I don't know. It looked like it could have gone either way.
Great down air. Just lands on top level with the down air. And Clubba trades with that up air. I feel like up air's got some like good space. Oh, my God.
Oh,
and
great edge guard.
Uppie, like, that was like far enough away so that it was like in the initial part, and Hammerheart calls him going to the ledge and just sneaks it on. Don't even
Hammerheart
get back
gets the reset and then wins grand finals.
Comes back before you can.